गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज योर इंग्लिश क्लास। यू टेक योर सेमिस्टर वन बुक पेज नंबर 42। वी स्टार्ट वन न्यू लेसन चिल्ड्रन। दिस इज लेसन नंबर 5। लेसन नंबर 5। सो लेसन नेम इज द शू मेकर एंड द एल। सी आई हैव रिटन हियर, आई विल मेंशन द पेज नंबर आल्सो चिल्ड्रन। ओपन द टेक्स्ट बुक पेज नंबर 42। पेज नंबर 42, यू ओपन इट, पिक्चर्स आर देयर, इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड। ओपन दिस पेज, this is semester 1 book. Now the story name is the shoemaker and the elves. Now see, when you're small and now also, now your mummy or your grandmother, they'll be telling so many stories. So this is also one fairy tale. So this is one kind of fairy tale. Now fairy tale means what? Tell me story, you know, T-A-L-E, tell. This is fairy tale. So some stories that is meant for children, they love to hear about fairies, then magic and all. So that was, this is one kind of fairy tale, and this fairy tale means story that for children, that is about fairies with magic power. So this is one fairy tale. Okay, the name is, story name is the shoemaker and the elves. Shoemaker, you understand, who makes shoes, we can call them shoemaker. And the now this one you should understand, elves. What is elves? So in stories, so many characters will be there. So that is one character is elf. So it looks like this. See, I try to draw. This is called elf. Elf is singular, means we talk about only one. That is elf. E-L-F. Elf. And it is plural is elves. Okay, plural is elves. So here you understood what is elves. E-L-V-E-S, it is plural of elves. So this is one character in story, elf, plural, because it is a story about one shoemaker and two elves. That is plural of elf. Okay? And it is a fairy tale. Fairy tale, this is not real, but for children, we tell so many stories. In that story, fairy will be there, elves will be there. They have some magic power. They love to hear all this story, but all the story will teach you something, something new. So this is fairy tale. That's this much you understood. Elves means plural of elf. Now what is elf? This character, what they say, no? They have very pointed ears. Pointed ears. Pointed ears. So these elves, they have pointed ears. They are very kind, very helpful, and whenever somebody is very poor or they need help, they will come and help. But we cannot see them. They come after midnight. Means night time they will come. When everybody will be asleep, nobody should see them. So this much you understood. Story is about shoemaker. The shoemaker means nowadays you don't get to see. Earlier people, no? They used to cut the leather, they used to stitch on their own. And they used to sell. Now ready-made shoes and all we buy from the showroom. But earlier days, people used to make. That is also one profession. They used to cut the leather from starting to finish. They only used to do. Single person. They are called shoemaker. Okay. So story is about shoemaker and the elves. Two elves are there in the story. Now open that textbook. Important lines I will read and I will explain. Shoemaker and the elves, lesson number 5. Once in a small town, there lived a shoemaker and his wife. They were very poor. The shoemaker worked hard but earned very little. As time passed, the couple grew poorer and the couple means what? A husband, wife. Two people together we call couple. We call them couple. C-O-U-P-L-E. So, in the first matter, what they say, a long time back, in a small village, one shoemaker used to live along with his wife. But they were very poor. Although that shoemaker was very hardworking and very honest, very good at heart, but how much he works hard also, he cannot earn enough money for his family. Day by day, they are becoming poorer and poorer. Poor means with no money. Opposite of rich means they didn't have enough money to feed his family. So he was very, very poor. So like that life was going on. One day what happened? Evening time, he saw he was left with only one piece of leather. So this much I rub first. I'll write here. So this much you understood. Elf means what? That fairy tale stories, some characters will be there. They are called elf. They have pointed ears. They are very kind and very helpful. They help the poor people. So fairy tale also you understood. Stories for children, where stories about fairies and characters with magic powers. These elves also, they had magic power. So this couple, they had no money. They are very, very poor. Okay, the shoemaker was very poor. Shoemaker was very poor. Poor means no money. So one day, what he saw, he had one piece of leather. Leather means animal skin. With that, people make shoes. People make footwear or shoes. So one day, what happened? He had only one piece of leather. Okay. So what he did now? He just cut it in two pieces. Then what he did now, it was already very late in the night. What he did, he made two pieces and he kept on his work table and he went to sleep. So this much you understood. He had left only one small piece of leather. With that, they make shoes. So he just cut it in two pieces and kept it on the table. One table, a work table, he used to stitching and all he used to do. So he kept it and he just went to sleep. A little more I will read for you. One day shoemaker saw that he had some leather just enough to make only one pair. Pair means one pair of shoes. So with this, only one pair he can make. So he kept it. So he was thinking, that was my last piece of leather. Tomorrow I'll make a pair of shoes. But what will become of us after that? So one leather he just cut and two piece. With that he can make only one pair shoes. He thought, now I'll go to sleep. Morning after breakfast I will stitch the shoes. So these two pieces he kept on the table and he went to sleep. Next morning what happened? He got up after breakfast. He went back to his work table. What he saw, you know, he saw instead of this leather piece, there are one pair of very beautifully stitched shoes. Somebody made and kept them. So one pair of shoes. So he was very surprised because he didn't stitch. He just then only got up and last night he just kept leather pieces. But morning it was ready. That shoe, one pair of shoe was already ready. So he was very surprised. Who did it? Next morning after breakfast, shoemaker went to his workshop. To his surprise, on the bench, he found a pair of shoes already made. He called his wife to have a look at them. I have never seen such well-made shoes, said the shoemaker's wife. Yes, indeed. The shoemaker and his wife did not know who had sewn the shoes. Now, sewn means one new word, sewn means stitch. S-T-I-T-C-H. The stitch means with needle and thread, they have to stitch. Then only they can make the shoes. So it was already sewn. Somebody did it. So they were very happy. Then that day, one lady customer, she came and saw the shoes and it was well fitted in her fit. It was fully fitted and she liked it so much, she bought it with so much money. With that money, next day, the shoemaker bought a very one big piece of leather. With that, he could make two pair of shoes. So he made it four pieces. Next day, he made four pieces, that leather piece, and kept it on the table. Once again, he went to sleep. Next morning also, somebody kept there two pairs of shoes next day. So first day, one pair. Second day, two pairs of shoes. Now it is neatly stitched and it was kept on the table. Next day also, he just sold that shoes. He got so much money. So next day, he got a leather piece that could make four pieces of shoes. So like that, it was just increasing, you know, day by day, it was getting increasing. So this much story you understood. One shoemaker was there long back, but he was very poor in the starting. So how much work he works at, but he could not earn enough money. Okay. He could not earn enough money. So what he did, no? One day, the last piece, what he cut in two pieces to make one pair of shoes, he left on the table and went to sleep. Next morning, somebody, unknown person, came and made that shoes and kept it there. So he was very happy. He sold it. He purchased a big piece of leather. From that, he could make two pieces of, two pairs of shoes. He just cut the leather and kept it and went to sleep. Next day, pairs of shoes was ready and it was kept. So like that, every day it was getting more and more. Understood? It was getting more and more. And they were becoming very rich also, because the shoes were made so well and it was well stitched. Design was also very nice. People started all over the place from the village. They started liking that shoes. And they come and purchase, and these people, they become very rich. Okay? So, starting they are very poor. Later on, After a few months, after a few months, he became rich. Okay? So, selling those well-made shoes, they earned so much money. They built a new house, and whatever they wanted, clothes, food, everything was enough for them. So one day, shoemaker's wife, she told that who is coming and helping us, we should know, so that we also say thanks for them. Understood? So now I'll read once again story. Later that day, a lady came into the shop. She looked at the shoes and said, "Are those shoes for sale?" So this much I told actually. So like that, every day, he was getting well-made shoes every day. And he was selling and he was earning much money. So, the next morning, there were four pairs of shoes without a single bad stitch. The same thing happened every day. Before he went to bed, the shoemaker would put the pieces of leather on the table. Next morning, he used to get ready-made shoes. So we are indeed lucky. So they thought we are very lucky. But wife told, "But who is doing this for us?" As the shoemaker, they just did not know. So they had an idea that, and these elves and all, they used to appear only in the midnight. What time they used to come? 12 in the night. 12 in the night. Where people will be sleeping. So that time they used to come very silently. They used to come at 12, night 12, midnight they used to come, they used to help and they used to go. So shoemaker's wife gave an idea that we will hide somewhere and we'll watch who is coming in the midnight and who is helping us. So that day, they just hid some place. Back of an old cupboard, they were standing there and they were watching. As soon as it was 12 o'clock, night 12 o'clock, they saw from the window, open window, two small elves like this, one boy, one girl. But they were wearing old clothes and they had no shoes, no footwear. They're very poor looking, but happily they came singing, dancing, and they were happily, they were, because they had magic power. They had magic power. So with the magic power, these two elves, they, within seconds, they made, how much leather was there? They made so many pairs of shoes and they kept, and they, once again, they disappeared from the place. Then shoemaker told, okay, now we got to know who is helping us. But you, they saw that elves are very poor. They didn't have proper clothes or they didn't have any footwear. So wife told, why can't we help them to say thanks for them? What we can do? We can make new clothes for them. We can stitch new shoes for them and we can prepare good food for them. So full day, they both the shoemaker and his wife, they stitched new shoes, they stitched new clothes and they prepared good food and kept on the, that day they didn't keep any leather because they had enough money. They become very rich now. So they kept here instead of shoes and they were hiding somewhere. Then correct midnight, the two elves, once again it came, but they saw there was food, there was new clothes for them and it was perfectly fitted for them. So they were very happy, singing, dancing. They wore the new dress, they wore the new footwear and they ate the food. Happily they went out and they didn't return back because this shoemaker, they had enough money, they don't need their help. So they went some other place who is in need, who are poor. So happily they went to some other place and they didn't return back. Okay, so that was the story. So it was a beautiful story. So this much you understood, I think. Few new words, I will tell you the meaning. One word, couple, I told you. Two people, one married man and woman. Okay, pair means, say, shoes and socks, we wear in two quantity, no? We call them pair, P-A-I-R, pair. So shoes and all, we always say pair of shoes. Socks also we say pair of socks. Elves, I discussed you, imaginary character in the fairy tales. They have pointed ear, they are very kind and they are very helpful. So only true and false, one exercise I'll do, then I'll continue next class, okay? Because it's a very long chapter. Exercise today in one day we cannot do. So only the true and false portion, because now only we read the story, no? So sentence is correct means we'll have to write true. So it is on page number 46. Now you should see page number 46. Shoemaker and so it was on page number 46. It is true and false, children. True and false. Okay, I'll read for you. The shoemaker earned a lot of money. No, it is false. He was very, very poor. How much he worked hard? Although he was very honest and hardworking, but he could not earn enough money. He was very poor. So sentence is wrong. You write false. The shoemaker had some leather to make a pair of shoes. The shoemaker had some leather to make a pair of shoes. Yes, he had last piece of leather. So that is true. Every night the elves made the shoes from the pieces of leather. Every night the elves made the shoes from the pieces. Yes, they used to come and they used to meet. So sentence is true. Number 4. The elves wore nice clothes. No, elves were also very poor. They didn't have good clothes. That is also false, right? False. Now this one, where are you writing, children? In the textbook directly. Right? False. The shoemaker and his wife got richer and richer. Yes, selling these shoes, no? Later on, they became richer. So they had enough money. So that is true. Okay, so one beautiful story I completed. Next class, I'll continue with the exercise. Once again, I'll tell you in short the story. So today up to here. Thank you, children. Have a good day.